I was listening to an interview that you did recently, and you spoke of suicide is up, depression is up, and everyone is jaded. Everyone is very jaded, which I found very jarring, but true at the same time, because you can't run away from the truth. It is what it is. You and the Zimbabwe Cares Network, and you know, everyone that is working actively towards, you know, trying to shift this narrative. I guess the question I have is, like, what does shifting the narrative look like for you? Because it can't end at a jaded reality of suicide and depression. There has to be some glimmer. And you spoke about, in that same interview, about, I think you said, sharing shreds of light to people. So the question is, what does shifting this narrative look like to you? Because things have to collectively get better, right? So what does that look like for you?
Okay, so there's a famous story about the little boy who was in the car with his mother, and they drove past an accident, and he was very distressed, and his mom said to him, "Don't look at that. Look at the helpers. It's a big accident. It's terrible, but look at all these people that are helping." And that is the perspective that the Zimbabwe Cares Network, I mean, just personally speaking, so many times, you know, when I'm feeling really down and just totally out of hope, and then I'll just look there and somebody will be saying, "Oh, we're doing this today, or we've done this, or look at this donation we got, and we did a medical outreach," or whatever it is. And I'm just like, wow, these people are in the same, we're in the same Zimbabwe. We're in the same boat, but look at them. I'm sitting here and I'm utterly miserable. But these people are out there going out on our terrible roads, and they're going with cooler boxes full of medicine, and they're going, but you know, with all this stuff, and they're going and they're helping people. Why? You know, they don't have to. They don't have to, but they're doing it. And you look at these selfless people and you think, This is the glimmer of light. This situation is so terrible, and it's so easy to just give up. But when you look at people like this, and you say, "Wow, these are the helpers. This is the light. These people that are still shining light." And sometimes you'll shine your light, and for them, because they're not superheroes. I'm not a superhero, so sometimes, you know, I'll shine my light for them, and then they'll shine their light. But as long as there's some source of light somewhere, we're okay. So this is the narrative, is that, again, we keep focusing on, if we just focus only on the negative, and I'm not telling you to focus on the positive. I'm telling you, focus on the negative, acknowledge it, and then look to the people who are helping the situation and get inspiration from them. Let them inspire you. Let them give you ideas of how you can help. And you can help from everything from, it can be as much as giving money, giving a whole heap of money to solve all of their problems, as big as that. Or it can be as small as sharing a Facebook post of these. It can be that simple. Literally tapping your finger twice on your phone. That's all it takes. And all of that means something. So when you're feeling like everything is terrible and everything is negative, look to the helpers and look for ideas of how you can do the same. How, you know, and it's just so great. And Zimbabwe Cares Network has saved me. It saved my mind and many people too. I have people who are members of the group. And they say, "Suraiya, you know, I have no way of helping. I'm out here in the UK or wherever, and I don't have a lot of money to give." But sometimes I just go into your page, and I hear so much bad stuff about Zim. Sometimes I just go to your page to scroll and say, "Ah, okay, those people are different." Like, it just makes me feel better that everything is not totally burning. You know, I still feel like there's glimmers of hope, and there's still life, and there's still life. And again, it's keeping your mental strength, and these kind of things mental state. I can't help today, but maybe tomorrow I'll help. This is how I'm going to do it. I'm going to be like them.